we've attempted to explain a little bit about Donald Trump, the drugs he's on, the recovery and all of that. But we're, you know, how much can we actually put into it money wise and production value? Fox has more resources. So when they had Dr. Oz on, here is a little animation they put together to help you understand what's happening to Donald Trump right now.
I think I sent you an animation. If you're able to show it, might be beneficial here. But the virus itself isn't the main culprit oftentimes. The virus, here you are seeing little virus particles. Those little red things are spike proteins. And they're looking for areas. There they are going into the president's nose. We don't know when it happened, but a couple days before he tested positive, down through his throat, into his lungs. Those little virus particles set up shop and begin to cause irritation. They attach to the little green receptors, like a key opening a door, they slip right in there, they take over the cell and they hijack the cell to release lots of virus, which you'll see exploding through here. Now here's the problem, that by itself doesn't hurt people as badly as what happens afterwards. Because when the virus is creating lots of areas of attack, the body's immune system, those white cells you see there come in, they attack, and then they start to fill up the lung, especially the alveoli, those purple little sacs, with fluid. And when they fill with fluid, you can't breathe. And if you wait too long, you have lots of damage to the lung.
Okay, so Dr. Oz is sort of a doctor, so he's trying to like educate people. But is that like, does Trump want them playing that animation, Francesca? Like over and over, like his lungs usually exploding with COVID?
Usually when we see Trump, something's like flying out of his nose that we don't know what it is. And I need more of an explanation about that. Look, hats off to Dr. Oz. I feel like this is the most comprehensive explanation of what coronavirus does to your lungs. That's and true. Your system that they've maybe ever had. They should have been showing this so far in advance. You know, I watch this and I think, I mean, what world are we in that only if the president, who is at this point, again, just a strongman autocrat, like, can we only care about coronavirus unless he has it? And apparently the answer is yes. Fox News will not take this seriously. They won't give you that animation of exactly what it does to your system. Because there's, look, there are tons of question marks around this virus, absolutely. But the question mark that doesn't exist is how it kills you. We know how it kills you. That's a perfect example, right? Too many white blood cells, it affects your immune system and your lungs fill up with fluid and you can't breathe and you die. So, and like this was stuff we were watching back in March, but I don't think that the Fox News viewers actually saw it. I mean, and if you haven't had an experience with COVID, you also don't know. So I'm just frustrated. But I do love seeing a little piece of COVID go in Trump's nose. I mean, this made me a little happy.
Oh my God. Crazy. That's the thing. Like Trump, if he watched that and it was on TV, so he does not want over and over his lungs exploding with coronavirus. He wants to appear strong and in charge and alpha. Not enough to actually exercise or anything, but he doesn't want the animation happening. And they chose a photo of Trump. I love that you were repeating that, Brandon. They chose a photo where Trump's like, as the coronavirus goes into him. That's weird. Why are you having him smile as it's going into him? That's like the person who made that animation, I'm not committed, is a Trump fan. I'm not sure that it's a Trump fan. But anyway, yeah, you're right. If it educates some people as to how the virus works, that's a good thing. I will dispute that this represents they're taking it seriously now, because I've been watching the takes on the right and they may have been finessing their talk about COVID, but I don't think they take it seriously. I mean, I'm not gonna be able to remember their names. There's like three other Ben Shapiros that you always see in right-wing media.
Sure,
I was gonna say it's the one that's like oddly obsessed with the trans community, but then I realized that's all of them.
All of them.
That's all of them. Said there's no point wearing masks because we're all gonna get coronavirus. I saw that video today. So it's not even the president can get it. Shouldn't we all take it seriously? It's he got it. There's no point doing anything. The surrender, the willingness to just preemptively surrender is just so pathetic. I wish that this had the silver lining, that it led to Trump fans taking it more seriously, wearing masks, socially distancing and all of that. But I don't think that at least 1 week in, we've seen good evidence of that.
I mean, this is the base that they created. This is the viewership that they've created. And now they're turning on them when Steve Ducey or Doug Ducey or whatever, Ducey. I just remember Ducey. Steve, right?
Steve.
When he, thanks. When he puts a photo of himself out wearing a mask, he gets completely clobbered by the right in the comments. And it's like, yeah, man, because this is what you did. This is what thou hath wrought in your viewership. The disbelief, the hoax, the denialism. This last week was also the week where we learned that Trump is the greatest spreader of misinformation around COVID.
Yeah.
And now he's got it. And yes, they're gonna spin it. But it for a moment there, I was like, maybe they'll take it seriously. Maybe there'll be a reckoning. But you know, it'll be just like China put it in my coffee, you know, or whatever it is.
Yeah. Yeah. And I'm gonna wait until a little bit later on. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.